When the Doors first went into the recording studio, we knew nothing about the recording studio. I had done a couple of things, a little bit of work with Rick and the Ravens, and Dick Bach showed us a few things, and, you know, how you mix. I was aware of how you make a mix, but as far as the technical workings of a studio, that was completely beyond me. So lo and behold, Jack Holtzman, the president of Elektra Records, who signed us, one day introduced us outside of the Whiskey A Go-Go, introduced us. He said, "Boys, I'd like you to meet your producer, Paul Rothchild." And here comes this hip dude from New York City, out of the folk scene, not out of the jazz scene, but out of the village, the Greenwich Village folk scene. And man, I took one look at him and said, this is one of the hippest dudes I've ever seen. This guy has a brain in that head of his. He is one smart cookie. Paul starts to talk a mile a minute. He's just going to town, man. He is full of excitement, full of energy. He's about 5 years older than I am. Great. Someone that I can look up to and a little bit more of an authority figure. I don't have to be the authority figure all the time. I'm 4 or 5 years older than the rest of the guys in the band. Frankly, I'm tired of being the authority figure. Paul, you're the authority figure in the recording studio. This is going to be absolutely great. He was definitely hip. He knew all kinds of things. Very literate. Jim and Paul hit it off immediately. Paul was very literate. I hit it off with Paul from a musical perspective. We just had a great relationship all the way through the whole thing. And we met Bruce and thought he was just super, man. The man was so technically astute and a very funny guy and a very sweet human being. So Botnick and Rothchild, they were the six Doors. There were four Doors in the recording studio and two Doors in the control room. The relationship between the six of us was absolutely magnificent. Paul was running the whole show. Botnick was doing the sound. Paul was helping him with the sound, judging the sound, and being the liaison between the musical creativity and expertise of the band and the technical expertise of Bruce Botnick. And he was the man who would go in between those two entities, those really non-compatible entities. But Paul Rothchild was able to bridge that gap just beautifully. And he was so creative and such a pleasure to work with in the recording studio.